Yeah, Mr.
Hello.
Allah knows best. Hello, you're live on air.
Hello.
Yeah, hello.
Oh, thingy. I think I called you a couple of days ago when you were talking about
Oh
Dao
yeah.
Pim.
Yeah, I remember you. You were about to leave Islam, right? I remember you. About
Yeah, I've.
chapter 5, ayah 47, right?
Yeah.
Okay, did you study it carefully, Mr.?
Yeah.
Okay. What
And I've left it.
you left Islam?
Yeah, I'm just going to.
Hallelujah! Welcome, my friend. Welcome to apostasy.
Yeah. I haven't
Wow.
thingy changed my Skype name though, so that's why it says Allah knows
Yeah,
best a lot.
okay, I
I'm gonna.
understand. So I'm happy for you, my friend. Can you tell me why you left Islam?
Well, of the verse that you showed me, chapter 5, verse 47, I
Yeah.
studied it carefully and I looked into it and I'm thinking like there's no way I could answer it. And I thought
Okay.
the only thing that makes sense is that Islam is false.
Yeah. Well, I'm so happy for you, my friend. Look, we always try to have nice and respectful discussions with Muslims, right? We don't hate any Muslim. Honest to God. I mean, my God is my witness. But when we go through the Quran, and you seem like a very humble, some very respectful guy, and I respect that. Didn't I tell you last time you forced me to respect you? Remember what I said to you? Didn't I tell
Yeah.
you that? Okay. So, and I'm really humbly saying to you, I'm happy that you used your brains and you left this man-made cult. Because in no way, shape, or form is Allah going to say that the Christians must judge by the gospel, by the Injil, right? And judge by it what is revealed in it, right? What is
Yeah.
revealed in it? That means if we Christians must judge by the gospel, we have to reject Allah and Muhammad. Because the Injil clearly states that Jesus is the Son of God. People worship Jesus. Jesus did not rebuke them. Jesus is the Son of God. He calls himself the Son of God. He calls God his Father. That contradicts the Quran. It contradicts Islam. So I'm happy for you, my friend. Can I invite you to become a brother in Christ? Do you want to pray with me and accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, my friend?
Well, I'm sort of new to Christianity,
Yeah.
so I always like I'm like if it's the truth, I'll be welcome to like
Okay,
join it. But
okay.
obviously, I want to take my time to like understand it
Sure,
first,
no
because if
problem.
I convert
Sure.
to it without knowing anything, I could easily just leave it. I
No
want to
problem.
like be sure
No
if
problem.
it's the truth.
Yeah, of course. You know, I understand that it was really hard for you, and I really respect your sincere gesture that you called me a couple days later, right now here, right here, right now. I'm really, you know, like I said, you forced me to respect you. All the people in the live chat, look at the live chat, they are going crazy. They respect you, they love you like I love you, my friend. I'm happy for you that you made your decision to leave this man-made cult. I'm happy for you. Take your time. Rome was not built in one day. So I want to ask you to go, for example, to BibleGateway.com or go to BibleHub.com. We have also admins in the live chat who can give you links, who can help you out. So please stay with us, stay in the live chat, and the admins are going to help you out so you can understand how which Bible website to go to. Maybe they can give you a Bible, or they can help you to learn how to deal with it, and you can start to learn about the Bible. Read it, my friend. You know, Jesus said, if you are seeking, I'm there for you. He is the shepherd. So if you ask God to guide you, he is there because you are a child of God. That's what Christianity and the Bible teaches. So my friend, only the truth and only the truth will set you free. And this is why we are here. We are not here for ourselves. We are not here for fame, like the Muslim apologists, right? You can buy the black seats and you will get 10% off, right? This is the commercial they're always playing in their videos, right? Like Ali Dawa and Muhammad Hijab. It's all about the money. But here, my friend, we only care about the truth. Nothing but the truth. Right? So, my friend, stay with us in the live chat. The admins and our friends there in the live chat will help you. And I'm really happy for you. Thank you for calling, my friend.
Thank you
Thank
for
you for calling.
helping me
I'm
leave
re
Islam.
thank you, thank you. No, thank you for being here. God bless you.
Thank you.
Thank you. And my friend, if you decide to accept Christianity, call me. I would love to pray with you. So you can accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Please call me. I'm your brother. All right?
Yeah.
Okay. Take your time.
I'll.
And would love to hear from you again, my friend. God bless you. I'm happy for you.
All right, thank you.
Thank you for calling. Thank you. Bye-bye. Wow. Wow, this gentleman, guys, called me a couple days ago, live on air. And he never heard of chapter 5, ayah 47 before. He never read it the way you should read it. And he understood there is no way of running from it. How can you, as Muhammad, we know this is written by Muhammad. This is the book of Muhammad, man. Muhammad wrote this. How can you command the gospel, people of the gospel, to judge by the gospel, but bust yourself so hard? How can you tell them to go to the gospel, judge by the gospel, but at the same time, you have no idea what the gospel is saying? If the Christians must judge by the gospel, they have to reject Muhammad, throw him in the garbage, and throw Allah in the garbage, because the Injil, the gospel, is completely destroying Muhammad. Guys, please, our audience who are watching, I love you. I respect you. You are my brothers and sisters in Christ. Please help this brother out. Take care of him. You know, take care of him. Help him, guide him to know where he needs to go. Help him. Maybe you can give him a good Bible translation. Help this brother out and keep him in your prayers. Keep us also in your prayers, guys, because you have no idea how many hate and death threat messages I get on daily basis. Help him, guys. This is the second guy in you know, you see me, maybe you see my video yesterday, right? I uploaded a short video of Fairuz accepting Jesus live on air. Wow, guys. Wow. This is why we do this, guys. This is why we do this. We do this for the truth. We serve the truth. We don't hate Muslims, man. Muslims, stop thinking that we hate you. We don't hate you. We only use tough love because you are different kind of people. We have to first break that wall that you made around you, which is the Islamic wall. Then maybe then you will be open for the truth. And this gentleman, I respect him. He forced me to respect him because he showed me that this guy can think for himself. He can think for himself. Stop listening to your lying and deceiving imams. If this guy can leave Islam, you can too. You can too leave Islam. God bless you, my friend. The gentleman who just called, God bless you. Stay safe. Don't give any information out. You know how Muslims treat apostates, right? So stay safe, you know. But look, keep searching. Read the gospel. Read the gospel, my friend. Jesus is inviting you back home. He is looking for you. Find him, man. Read the Bible and find him. He and only he, the name above all names, the King of Kings, Jesus himself, will guide you if you ask. If you ask, he will provide. God bless you, my friend. Lord Jesus, I pray to you to open all these Muslim eyes. Shine your holy light on all of them, God. Please, God, shine your holy light upon all of them, like this gentleman who just left Islam. Please, Lord, I pray to you. Glory to your holy name, Jesus Christ. Glory to your name. The name above all names. Thank you so much. Thank you for so much to open this person's eyes. And Lord Jesus, please guide him. Guide him to come back home to you, oh Lord Jesus. And every knee will bow and proclaim that Jesus is Lord. Amen to that. Amen to that. I'm happy for you, my friend. I'm happy for you. God bless you. God bless you.
Now that's fresh mountain-grown coffee from the hills of Colombia.
The rise of apostasy. People are leaving Islam at unprecedented rates. The narrative of Islam being the fastest-growing religion is no longer true. The Muslim community is now in damage control from this new threat. Dr. Bilal Phillips, in a recent Friday sermon, openly has warned the Muslim community that apostasy will come like a tsunami.
And if we don't take constructive steps to deal with this, it is going to become an avalanche, a tsunami, that is going to hit our community in such a way that we will have a very difficult time standing. It will knock us over.
Right.
هذا هو اليوم الذي صنعه الرب فلنفرح ولنتهلل به المسيح قام من بين الأموات ووطئ الموت بالموت ووهب الحياة للذين في القبور المسيح قام من بين الأموات ووطئ الموت بالموت ووهب الحياة للذين في القبور المسيح قام من بين الأموات ووطئ الموت بالموت ووهب الحياة للذين في القبور Christos anesti epnekron thanaton, thanaton batisas, ketis entithnimas izoif, karis amenos. Messiah,